On May 31st of 1998, Rare released a game known as Banjo-Kazooie for the N64 and became one of the best action platformers in its library. But what made this game infamous was a cutscene shown at the end of the game where a certain shaman presents the player with cards of different colored eggs and an ice key if they beat the game 100%, collecting all 100 jiggies. Surely all that hard work would pay off, right? Well, Mumbo would then tell the player that collecting these items would be useful in the next game in the series, Banjo-Tooie for the N64. This caused a huge demand for the next game in the series and was seen as a great idea by Rare as it got players hyped up and ready for the next installment. But unfortunately, the idea for Stop and Swap was scrapped later for several reasons and was never really fully used as originally planned. But the question is, why would Rare keep the Stop and Swap ending knowing its functionality can never be performed? All these questions have caused a ton of controversy over the years until players, myself included, have finally solved this unbreakable mystery once and for all. So I'm YankeeGamer5 and this is the complete history of Stop and Swap. Stop and Swap was a way to transfer data from between Rare's two Banjo N64 games. The idea was to collect these items in Banjo-Kazooie, then transfer them via swapping out your cartridge for the other one, Banjo-Tooie, and unlocking many hidden secrets in the process after this transferring of data was complete. This would be the only way to get exclusive content for Banjo-Tooie, which was clever by Rare to make you buy both the prequel and the sequel. Well, Rare went ahead and implemented a good amount of it into Banjo-Kazooie, but little did Rare know that what they were going to do was create one of the biggest mysteries in video game history. Alright, first of all, the method that Rare was trying to use to transfer the data from one game to another was known as hot swapping at the time. This means that the player would pull out his or her Banjo-Kazooie cartridge with the power on, note that, and then jam in the Banjo-Tooie cartridge and voila, done. This method is the whole reason it's called Stop and Swap. You're supposed to stop your game and perform a hot swap. Thanks to the 10-second memory of N64 models before 1999, you could have changed cartridges to get the desired items in Stop and Swap. It would work as originally planned. But this leads us into Stop and Swap's first failure, which was revisions in the N64 circuitry. According to MTV Multiplayer, the reason Nintendo soured on the idea was because revisions to the N64 circuitry. Older versions of the system would have given gamers a full 10 seconds to remove the Kazooie cartridge and insert the Tooie one. Newer iterations of the N64 would have given gamers just 1 second. So plain and simple, a hardware upgrade doomed Stop and Swap by giving only 1 second to swap out the cartridges, proving it to be virtually impossible. The final nail in the coffin for Stop and Swap was, according to Nintendo, that this method of transferring data was considered highly dangerous and could seriously harm your N64. So with the fear of potential lawsuits on both sides, the idea of hot swapping was scrapped once and for all. After Banjo-Kazooie was released, players tirelessly began the search for the different colored eggs and ice key, but resulted in failure. This was until, by use of a Game Shark code, a player not only moon-jumped through the wall to collect the ice key, well, that sounds weird, but discovered something greater. In the pause screen, when you view totals, there is now one more screen after Click Clock Wood. This is the Stop and Swap screen. 2 years later, users at the RareWitchProject.com, known as Ice Mario and Subdrag, hacked Banjo-Kazooie to unlock the Sandcastle codes that give you the ice key and eggs in the N64 version of Banjo-Kazooie. Here are the codes you can enter in the N64 version of the Sandcastle to unlock the ice key and the egg locations. Hey, but who knows? Maybe you'll guys see that game in the near future. And now, after all that, what do you guys say we collect some stop and swap items? Alright, so the first item we're gonna go for is actually the ice key in Waz's cave now that's activated with the cheat. And basically, the reason I had to use the cheats was because I don't have Banjo-Tooie or Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts on my game file, but there it is. The ice key. Isn't it beautiful? Look how big it is. But anyway, triumphant roar! Cool! Enormous ice key! We should keep this stop and swap item for later. Alright, so that's how you get the ice key using the Sandcastle cheats. So yeah, you had to use the cheats on the Xbox Live version because of that. Normally, if you just had Banjo-Tooie, like I said before, or Nuts and Bolts, they're all activated pre-activated, I should say. And now the stop and swap item screen is activated with the ice key in hand. Or if you collected any of the items, it shows up after Click Clock Woods. So let's get the next stop and swap item. Ah, greetings from Treasure Trove Cove, or should I say Shark Food Island. So yes, we're gonna go inside of the Shark Food Island. This is where we saw the cutscene in Mumbo's card. So yeah, we have to, okay, we're already failing. So we have to go climb all the way up on this mountain and get to it. So yeah, if you pretty much couldn't tell, this is post-narrated because I thought it'd be much more organized just to have this as a post-narrative and just record all the areas and stuff. Because I would have been recording for like 20 minutes just to get these 7 things, and to have them all bunched together pre-made already, it makes it a ton easier when editing and stuff and pre-recording. You'll get it when you LP someday, kids. So anyway, let's just hop up on here and get that pink egg that we saw on the card. And triumphant backflip. Whoa! Another one of those special stop and swap eggs! Hope this isn't a cruel joke and we can actually use them this time. Oh, I love that line right there. Aw, Rare. You make fun of yourself sometimes. I love you. Alright, off to the next one. Greetings from Pocket Sand Land, or Gobi's Valley for you peasants. And yes, every time we find a stop and swap egg, that pretty much goes as the theme of it. And you can notice the theme is similar to the one you can hear in Donkey Kong 64 when you're about to enter a boss room. Yeah, that's the same thing. And there we go, we get the other egg. The blue one this time. Ooh, an egg! That's one of the 7 stop and swap items we've been looking for. I reckon it'll unlock something special in my Nuts and Bolts adventure. Can't wait. Yeah, can't wait. Pulling a Bart Scott right there. Alright, off to the next one. Okay, we're in Mad Monster Mansion here. And as you said, Banjo said before, you can use these items in both. I don't know why Rare always said Nuts and Bolts, but you can actually use the items in Banjo-Tooie. I don't know why they keep on saying you can only use them in Nuts and Bolts, but you can use them in Dual Axis. And yeah, Banjo, take a dump. You've earned it. You had a long adventure. Alright, into the cellar. Same world. I don't know why they have 2 stop and swap eggs in Mad Monster Mansion. And it's by the 1882 barrel. That's, I think that was the first game Rare made. Yeah, that's why I looked it up afterwards. And that was the reasoning. So off to the next one. Alright, another cool fact about the stop and swap eggs. Oh, wrong area. I guess I'll talk while I get to it. Is that for some reason, I think you were only supposed to find the ones in the cards and the ice key. There's only supposed to be 2 eggs and the ice key. The other eggs are just like sloppily put into worlds and there's no like special way of getting them. Which I've noticed with the Treasure Trove Cove one, you have to hit the island. Like, look at it, it's just on the bed. You didn't have to do anything to get it, and I'll just kill you out of the heck of it. So yeah, it's kind of weird, you just have to, that the other 2 require you actually do stuff, while these other eggs are just put into random worlds. And the last one is actually in the winter side of Click Clock Wood. So, let's just see here, where is it? It's on a table, I think. Because I actually came here in the springtime thinking it didn't matter what season it was, and I guess it does. Hey, Banjo, we found all the stop and swap items! Time to ditch the checklist and stash them away for use in Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts. Ah, man, Nuts and Bolts. I know I give that game a bad rap, but it's not the best. But I've played it before, just so you guys know, so I'll just meet you back at Spiral Mountain. Alright, so we're back here in Spiral Mountain, and we're actually in front of Banjo's house right now. You're wondering to yourselves, why are we here? Didn't we beat the whole entire game? No, we actually missed one more thing that we can do in this game that is in Banjo's house, and not a lot of people know about it, so let's go inside and I'll show you what it is. What you can actually do is throughout the game, or I think if you beat the game, I'm not sure, I'll put it up in annotation if I'm wrong. You can do these challenges that Bottles gives you by looking at his picture over the fireplace. So by doing that, he gives us a set of challenges to do, and he gives us some cheat codes in order to do some funny things to Banjo, which I might show, I probably will at the end of when I'm doing the puzzling, just for the sake of completion of this LP. And the cheat codes aren't really that long, as long as the freaking ones I had to type in before. And circle round the carpet, circle round the carpet, circle round the carpet, yeah, yeah, yeah. Alright, so anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. It was kind of different than the ones I normally make, so a lot of work went into it, and I'm really happy how it turned out. So anyway, yes, next time we will tackle the Bottles picture challenges. So see you later, guys, or puzzle challenges, and until next time, I'm coming for you, Bottles!